Now then, welcome back to another episode on Hypermine Modded, HyperAntix. Welcome back. How are you doing today? There were a lot of really cool comments and ideas on last episode, episode number one. If you did not leave a comment and you have an opinion, please make sure you go back and leave your comment down below on episode one. I am interested in your comments. If you don't know what I'm on about, go and watch episode one and find out what I'm on about. I will deal with that and talk more about that in another episode. I want to give you a bit more time to leave some comments for me down below on episode one. So, without further ado, what's going on today? Well, as you can see, I've got a tree farm going. Yeah. And you remember in last episode, episode one, me creating this prime real estate and leveling it all off and fencing it all off? Well, look, the corporations have come along and put a great big advertising sign right next door overlooking my property. There is nowhere else that this could possibly be pointing other than in my property. So it's blatant advertising. And, if you don't know what this is, Bleak Sunrise Retirement Acres, well, you haven't been checking out the links in the description and checking out the other YouTubers that are putting videos out. There has been a village set up somewhere on the server. I'm trying to remember where it is, actually. They've set it up over here. Here it is, over here. And it has been set up by Lapis and DarkphanLP, and I think Runwyld was helping as well during the episode, to set up a place for villagers to breed and chill out and all that kind of stuff. And it is called a retirement home. Bleak Sunrise Retirement Acres. Yes, and they've obviously put this up as well to advertise the fact. So there you go, there's their bit of advertising. I don't mind that it's there, but now it's been advertised. Can it come down, please? Can it come down, please? Because it's right in front of my plot, and I'm going to have to build something in front of it right here if I'm going to have to look at it all the time. Oh, you think you get a good place, and then all of a sudden a billboard appears right outside. Dang. So I've been busy over here. I've been busy doing some more building. Some more building work's been approved by me. I spent many hours changing this around a little bit. I started building this property, this building here, and I liked the style that I had picked when I started doing it, so I came back and I refreshed this one to match in so that they're both very similar. The similar style of build. It is stone bricks around the outside edge for three blocks up, and I've made those windows a bit smaller. They were actually up a bit higher. And now we've got some windows up here. But these windows, as you can see, the inner wall, like the plaster wall on the inside, is a lot different than before. This is now using the chisel and bits. I'm using chisel and alabaster to make these little sections here. And I quite like it. I quite like it a lot. It's really cool. I like it. I was thinking about putting full blocks in to do it in vanilla style, but this has given me a lot more room. No more room for putting things down because this still takes up the full block, but more room to walk around in and more room to rest in and check things out in, and no attic space. But I should be able to put something in the middle at least and have a walk around it, so that's good. And also, there's another little thing that I've been trying to work on, which was setting up some windows. Some nicer windows. I was looking at these windows, and I kind of like that. I kind of like it. I think I'm breaking that. Yeah, I'm broke it. Dang it. So I want to upgrade these windows as well to the newer windows. So I'm going to start with that and show you what I'm doing. All I really need to do is go around breaking the old window and then placing this one in a connected plane. So it just fills in that little gap there. That means that I could probably chisel away some of this as well. Shall I just place that in and then chisel away at bits like that? How many is that? 5, 6, 7, 8. I could make that just half a thing if I wanted. But anyway, So this comes out to there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Nah, there we go. Okay. It should be 8, shouldn't it? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yes. Okay. Awesome. And again, break it here. And then put this on here. Doing a little bit of chiseling bits in today because I want to get it all set up nicely. It's spawn. 7, 8. There we go. And then this one should just... that should be 8. Yeah. Yeah, I just want to set a few things up at spawn and make things look nice and tidy. That needs breaking as well. And yeah, okay. So the next thing that I can do is take a little bit off the inside edge of it to give me enough glass to do these other bits. There we go. And if I take two off there, 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 they're all now a little bit smaller. Hey, Dark Fan, how you doing? Yeah, just enough to give them a little bit of a recess. That's nice. Nice enough. And then this one, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And then come inside and take that little bit off again for the recess. 1, 2. There we go. And I've got myself a little chisel bits bag so that I can store all this stuff in the chisel bits bag. Oh, there's loads of chisel bits glass in there. Good, good. Okay, so yeah, that's that one done. I'm also thinking how to do the upper floor so I get those windows in as well. That's the next thing. And I'm also trying to figure out, or I've been trying to figure out, now I think I've figured it out, how to get grass up in here in order to have like window boxes. And I've been looking at the grass and thinking I should build up to get it to mature and move up there properly. But I haven't yet figured it out. I'm thinking of testing out chisel and bits to see if that will do the job for me. So let's get some dirt on the bar. And let's chisel out 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Let's do 6 of them, right? And then take this block up. Whoa, give me that. Take these blocks out, right? And this is kind of silk touching in a way because it's guaranteed to be grass blocks again once I put them back together up here. So in this building, this is already done with the windows. I did the windows just a small amount inside there on most of them. Yeah, I think most of them are done. All the downstairs windows are done. Yes, they are. But there's only one block of... There's only one pixel of window in these ones, so it's slightly different from the other one. But I am trying to keep slight differences. I do like to keep slight differences. We're going to put... I think we're going to put it here. So these grass blocks, right, that we've just chiseled, I'm going to put one there. I'm going to put one there. I'm going to put one there. One there. One there. And one there. Okay, and now I've got the grass blocks here because at the minute I won't be able to place anything on it. So I can place the grass block and then it becomes a full grass block again. Now it's a full normal Minecraft grass block again, and I've transferred it up without needing silk touch. Oh, look at that. It works perfectly. So that turns it into grass again. Yes. Awesome. And then I could just put a couple of blocks either side so that the grass grows across onto those blocks. And then we've got ourselves some planters. Now, the idea here, again, is to go round with the alabaster on the inside to make the window sections. Let's do this. We'll get some alabaster. Let's get another couple of blocks worth of alabaster stored away. And also the windows. So we've got those sorted out as well. There we go. And just grab all this. Dump it all in my bag so I get plenty for the stock that I'm about to use. I'm so glad we got bags, because half a block just literally kills all of your inventory in no time whatsoever. The bags are awesome. Bomb. There we go. And the bag is half full. Look, that's 20,000 little bits of alabaster in there. But all I need to do is do a connected plane thing. So let's start in this corner here and do a connected plane there. We can do a connected plane there. There. No, I didn't want connected plane. I wanted, I wanted that one. So full. No, I want plane, not connected plane. Plane, that's it. Okay, so there. Now it puts a full thing in. That's it. And then we go there. Okay, and I can put one up there and bring it down here. And then take that back out. You right click to place it, and you left click to take it off. So I can do that all like that. And it will do connected planes. So there we go. So that's how I'm going to get the window sorted out. So there's window boxes on the outside of the window with a few flowers in to looking out. That's that job done. I just need to go round and secure them all in the right places. There's a little trick to it there. You just grab it and then you can extract it back again. And on there, just do that, and then you can grab it back again. It's kind of like a placer block, just to be able to put it in the right place. And that's going to make the place look very, very tidy indeed. Very, very tidy. It does look like, though, like I'm going to need to do something under here with the spruce wood, just to bring the stairs in line properly. But I'll mess around with that later. I've just got to get all of these in place first. I could even bring it fully across like this and have it a full white wall. I could just cover it all over and just plaster the walls fully, but I'm not sure that I want the full wall plastered. It looks okay, but it does mean that I've got no wall storage space. I can't do any storage space on the walls there if I fill it all in like this. And then how am I going to get the glass on? I'm going to need to do glass like this, I think. If I put glass on like that and then hack the glass off, it becomes a full panel or pane, and then I can bring it over and put it into the window just there. And place it in so that we get the windows in as well. Windows for looking out. Awesome. So yeah, that's nice and simple, isn't it? That's nice and simple. Nice, easy ways to do things. I'm going to need some more glass though to get this done properly. But still, there and there, and then another one on here in a bit. Yeah, so I've got to do all of this kind of building out just to get this section done. And then once I've got that all sorted, then we can look at what we're going to do to fill in the space and what we're going to put in here. And there's a few other little things that I want to do today in this episode. Not just show you all the things that I've been doing, but also setting up the insides of the buildings like this as best as I possibly can, including all the downstairs. Let's have a look at how that looks from out here. Yeah, they look pretty good. I like those. And then I will get some... I think I will use spruce. I think I did spruce earlier. Yeah, there's oak trapdoors and there's spruce trapdoors. Melissa doors or quark do extra in the way of doing these. So let's turn this into a little garden area, look. So that'll look pretty good. And I may also put oak trapdoors in the windows there to look like window shutters, just because. I might do that. Or I might put pots on those, I don't know. I just thought it would be a little bit more interesting doing things this way around, just to see how it would look overall. To try and make my spawn house look nice. The basics of my spawn house, it's all just here just to get me started, isn't it? It's not really here for any other purpose. I'm going to be moving away. Once you've had your say on episode one, we're going to be moving somewhere else and starting our main build. But I would like my spawn build to look great before I leave. So I'm just going to finish off the inside there and get the windows in places. Okay, I'm kind of digging it. I can see what's going on. I like it. I've done all the insides and all the windows, and I've started messing around with trapdoors. Putting the trapdoors on the edges of what will be the window boxes, the grass blocks, once they've all set up growing across. And I put trapdoors on the ends of these logs that stick out. And I kind of like that. I think that's pretty good. I may try something with roofs in a minute. I may try a few things with roofs in a minute, because there's a new block in town from missing pieces. The other thing I tried was just doing it either side of the window, just to see the difference between them. And I think I prefer the one without the trapdoors around the window. But the trapdoors on the end instead. Yep, that's a good idea. The thing that I've spotted that is available is a mod called Missing Pieces. Let's do Missing Pieces, which does like pillars, rounded pillars of wood and various clays and all that kind of stuff. Also wedges, as in slopey wedges, some shelving, and some chandeliers, or candelabras, as they are here, and lamps and thing, and chairs and tables and stuff. All looking pretty good, all looking pretty awesome. So what I've been doing is making spruce stairs to do my rooftops. So I'm going to give the spruce slopes a go. I'll just do a few for now. I can do more in my inventory because it's only a small pattern as well. So that's good. I like that. And we'll test that out on this roof here. Just because I want to see how good these slopes actually look when they're in place. So I'm going to run out of axe as well. Dang it. I better do that first. Best get me axe out first. Get a new axe. I'm so organised. I'm so ready for this episode today. So ready. As you can see, I've been smelting down loads of iron. Did a lot of mining and sorting stuff out. So I'm good to go. I should really make myself a diamond one, because I've got a load of diamonds that I've got picked up from down in the mines. The mine shaft is looking pretty good. I'm getting quite a lot of stuff from it. And filling in all the like spawnable ground as well. I wanted to do that as part of the whole job. Let's get this out of here. Right, there we go. So I'll take these off. They have a block underneath already, because that is what I've been filling in the rooftop with. So I'm just seeing what these slopes will look like. I don't know if I'll do the cobblestone slopes as well. I might leave the cobblestone stairs for now and see how they look as they are. Right, let's see. So slope, 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 slope. Yeah, I like. It's kind of funky. I could do with maybe doing a tile, like a clay brick tile effect instead of this, but oh well. We'll survive. Let's do one whole wall and see what it looks like. Ah, is a potential issue. How do they fit together? They do fit together nicely. Good. They place just like stairs do, which is very good. Okay, and I can have some more of those. Oh, no, I can't do them in there. I've got to do them in a big crafting. Oh, well, there's a slight issue, but I suppose there must be some reason why it's not doing it in a 2x2 crafting grid. Maybe there's a reason. I'm doing stairs again. Maybe there's a reason, maybe not. But I can transfer all of these over fairly quickly, and we can see how this looks. So how's it looking so far? Well, so far so good. So far so good. So far so good, it looks okay. I'm not sure, to be honest. I thought about doing it with chisel and bits, and I'd have ended up with the same shape, the same exact shape overall. But I wanted to see, well, I guess I wanted to see what these new mods are doing to add dimensions to Minecraft that we haven't explored before in any of my Let's Plays. Just the slopes and round circular bits. Give me, oh no, it's gone. Okay, well, I can stay there then. Just these slopey bits just intrigue me. We haven't had a carpenter's blocks for a while. I don't know about Carpenter's Blocks being updated. I'm guessing Carpenter's Blocks is going to be updated some more. They don't quite trim in together, do they? It's kind of a little ridge on top, which doesn't make that they smooth straight in. Well, I suppose it could be worse. Oh, it means I can climb this wall, because I can get up on top of that block and then jump up. Uh-huh. Okay, well, I can climb the whole roof now. I'll leave this end bit, or shall I? No, let's take it. Let's take it off. Let's take it off so we can have a proper test. And can I place it while I'm standing on the stairs? Only if I go there, I doubt. Yes. Okay, let's try. Let's get rid of it all. And let's see. Can I place this when I'm standing on top of it? No. Can I place... Hey! I fall straight down off that, though. Well, thanks. Thanks, game. Thanks. Okay. Let's try that a different way. Let's try that this way. And do this. And that. Yeah. Will let me. Will it basically hit the space that we try and jump it onto? Yes. Okay. And on top of these stairs, I should be able to place another one. Oh, it does corner ones as well. That's pretty awesome. It does corner ones as well. But I don't want a corner one in this case. I want a straight bit. Okay, that's awesome. I like the way that it changed to match in with a corner of a rooftop. That's very good. I like these missing pieces blocks. I'm not sure if I want to keep it on my roof, though. Not sure if that's how I want it to be. Ooh, but then again, that's pretty cool looking, isn't it? I like that. I like that a lot. Okay, let me do some more tinkering, and I'll show you the final result. Okay. It's getting there. It's getting there. It's getting there. I did the sloped roof, both sides, and it looks okay. But there's something about a standard Minecraft stairs, stepped up roof that just seems kind of feels a bit more real in Minecraft. I don't know. Maybe it's because I've got used to using stairs as roof tiles instead of using slopes. Just maybe that's all it is to it. Maybe it needs a little bit of getting used to. Maybe putting the cobblestone slopes on as well will help. But there's just something that makes that look more rugged and in keeping and regular and normal than that. That looks just a little bit odd. Maybe it's the extra little bit of shade here and there as it goes up. I don't know. But I'm happy with them. I've put some flowers in now as well. I've planted the flower pots out, so it looks pretty good. And I've started doing this garden. I want to finish this off in a second. But now upstairs looks really, really nice, because you come upstairs and you've got the beautifully white painted area with little window boxes. Little window boxes and a little bit of a sparkle from a botanical flower sitting outside the window every once in a while. Very good, very good. I like. And it's a good view as well. You get a good view still. Yep, I like it. Nice. The thing that I'm stuck on a door. The thing I'm working on now is just setting up a little farm. Not a farm for farming's sake. A farm for decoration's sake. That's where the farm's going to be. And I've started trying to figure out what I want to do between these two doors here. Because of hidden lighting and stuff. I want to hide a little bit of lighting. So let's have a quick sleep. Quick as slipper. I've only just earned the achievement, time to farm, as well. Because, I don't know. I guess I didn't have myself a wooden hoe before I made a crafting table or something. I don't know. Maybe I picked up a wooden hoe from somewhere instead. So all I'm doing with this is I'm going to bring it up, across, and over like this. Just to connect the two together. But I'm leaving a little gap down the middle, right? So we end up with a bit of an arching archway, yes. And then I think I'm going to do the same sort of thing where I can connect these to the wall here. I'm not sure exactly how this is going to work, so bear with me. This is experimentation. But we're going to go up one, two, and then in like that, connecting to that window frame, maybe that'll look okay. Let's have a look. How does it look? It doesn't look too bad, actually. Yeah, it doesn't look too bad. Yeah, that's okay. That's okay. It's in keeping with what I'm planning anyway. And I would like to do this one as well. Just to try and link in the framework of the outside along with the framework of the inside. Yeah, that'll do. I don't actually need it in the window there, do I? Let's change that up a little bit. Pop over there and over it. And let's get rid of that one there. Yes, and give me. Thank you. Okay. And then I want to add in some greenery so that I can cover these up with greenery. So I was thinking of building a tree, a custom tree, right in the center here. Started working up here. I don't know if I should have oak or spruce. I think I should probably have spruce or birch. I know there's a load of spare birch at spawn. Should we go and have a quick look at spawn? I've been using loads of oak, and I've been using lots of spruce for other things. This has run out again, has it? Yeah. Okay. So, with the birch forest behind me, maybe I should do a cool-looking birch tree. Now, that's going to take me ages to messing around doing a custom birch tree, but I'll mess around with it off-camera, and I'll show you later. It shouldn't be too difficult. I don't want it just straight, though. I don't want it just straightforward. I want it to be a big one. And this is firewood, free firewood, and it just happens to be birch wood logs. So let's take a stack of those and we'll head on back. There's also a beacon over here already. Man, they're working so fast because they're all streaming. They're all live streaming. You can check the link in the description to the Reddit page to find out all the video makers if you're into your YouTubes. And if you're more into streaming as well, then that's cool because you'll be able to find lots of people who are streaming from the HyperAntix server. Okay, so let's start out by giving it a bit of this, and we can also set a little root system going off in here, and a little bit over here as well, just to make it look like there's roots for it. Okay. And we'll pop another one this side as well. Yeah. I don't want to connect it to the fence though, so we'll stop with that. And this can have two high and then come up this way. Yeah, that'll do. Alright. Well, maybe I'm doing this custom tree here after all. I just kind of want to make a few branches coming out. Let's go a branch out this way and a branch out here. Let's branch it out this way a little bit. Let's go this way a little bit. And across a little bit. And across a little bit more. Just a little bit. And then maybe we'll branch out from here with this one to come over the farm slightly. I don't want to cover the farm with any solid blocks, though. So that'll possibly do it. First time. Well, there's not that much space to make a custom tree. So, yeah, that's not a bad starting shape for it. Now we just add a load of greenery, and that might actually look good. Let's see, do I put the greenery in here? Hey, get out of my face. Did I put the greenery in here? There's some oak leaves in there, okay. We can also add in some more fences and things, propping it up slightly to make it look like it's propped. I did have a load in here. Yes, I did. Awesome. Loads of oak leaves. Alright, so one thing that I want to achieve is having this kind of showing up as a support for the tree. So it's kind of supporting the branches in a way. So I can have a little overhanging section coming down like this. So this is very, very simple, but I do want to have it extended over this way a fair ways as well, so we can have it connected up to this side as well. Yeah, kind of like this. I just want enough to give us some interest in this area. Let's just get a lot done in a straight line where I want the bulk of it to go. And then we can kind of bring it down a touch in places and make it feel like it's connected to the wall over here a bit. And grow it up the wall a little bit over here. Let's get it up there. Nearly. And connect it like that a little bit. Take a few steps back, check it out. Yeah, against the backdrop, that's okay. I just want to flesh it out and bring it over this way a bit more as well. Just so that this tree has a lot of character and a lot of life to it around here. And it is just random placement. That's all I can ever suggest to anybody if they're making their own tree, is just a little random block placement in what you would consider a tree-like shape. And it works a treat most of the time. But if you want, you could follow a Minecraft tree and just redo a Minecraft tree. But that never really looks realistic in my eyes, anyway. And a little bit more over here. A little bit overhanging. We'll come down a little bit over here. And down this way a little bit. Just randomly bring it out and have a few overhangs here. So yeah, I think that's working. I think it's working. We're getting a rough shape. I will work on it more between episodes, but we're getting the rough idea that I want it just to be something between the two buildings. I'm gonna go up a lot higher, I think I'll need another little branch out. Just a little branch out on the side there, just so I can have another little bit on the top there. And just get that custom tree, just to separate the two buildings a little bit. And give me some cover. When I'm coming between these two, I would like to have the cover going on. Which means that this gets a bit of a bushy look about it. Like a so. Just kind of growing out of the root system of it. I think that might work. Let's go that way. And I can also throw a few of these in that I harvested earlier. Some grass. And some large plants and some other flowery type stuff here and there as well. Let's put a little flower just there. Why not? And a big grass there. We can bone meal that later and make it a bit bigger. That'll work. And that's just hiding the lighting in a way. Hiding the lighting, working its way up, being supported by these frames, and I'll make a frame go up this way a little bit so we can have it coming down the corner of this building here as well. Put it all around the corner here. I've got to do a lot of bulking out for it. And I would like to get some leaves of slightly different texture as well. So I might chop down some spruce tree leaves and add some of those in there. And against the backdrop of the farmland being all full of various crops, I'll probably just plant like little rows of everything. So a little row of interesting looking plants that grow into food. I'll probably never harvest them unless I'm really hungry, in which case it's only a right click and I don't even need to replant. So overall, guys, that is what I've got for today's episode. I hope you like the build. I hope you like the building. I will be checking out the comment section from episode 1 once again. I will be checking that out to see if we can come to some sort of agreement with what you would like to see me do and what I would like to do. And give me some ideas for where this series should go, what the epic build base is going to be. But at the minute, I'm going to be pottering around spawn, doing these kind of things in this house and that house. And I'm also planning a great big house right where I'm doing the tree farming at the minute. So it should be quite a nice plot at spawn by the time I'm finished. But that is all I've got time for today, folks. Thank you very, very much for watching. I will see you in the next episode. A goodbye.